Hi guys, it's Rach. So it is the weekend, which means it's time for another Scent Saturday video. This one will probably go up a little bit late, the same as my last week's video, but my last week's video was a perfume collection, which was highly requested, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you haven't had a chance to see it yet, I will put a link to it right here, so you guys can check out what perfumes I have and maybe what perfumes will be featured in the upcoming Scent Saturday videos. But when I was filming that, I actually mentioned some of my favorite perfumes, and I thought it would be a good idea to do videos on them so you guys can hear a little bit more about them. And one of them is the Harajuku Lovers G perfume. This is actually a fairly recent purchase of mine. I got it the end of last year, but already it is one of my favorites. I absolutely love it. This is the little 10ml bottle, but it also comes in 30ml and 50ml. I'm not sure if it comes any larger than that, but this is a bottle that it comes in two parts. So the top part is a little doll and the bottom part is shaped as a little pedestal, and this is the part that actually holds the perfume. And I think they're really, really cute. Each doll has its own unique style, and it's actually based on different people in Gwen Stefani's life. So this is G, which is actually based around Gwen herself. And then there are four other perfumes, Love, Little Angel, Music, and Baby, which are all based around her four backup singers and their stage names. So each has their own unique style, and then from the original five perfumes, which came out in 2008, they've all been little spin-offs on the original of each of those five perfumes. So I think it's a really cool concept. Each of the perfumes have a little story written on the box so you can read about where the inspiration from the perfume came about, which I also think is really, really cool. But I love this perfume so much, I think, because it reminds me of summer. The main scent, or the main thing that I can smell when I spray this perfume, is coconut, and it is not a too overpowering coconut smell, but if you like the smell of like coconut oil and that reminds you of summer, then I think you'll really, really like this perfume. So this perfume features top notes of mandarin, fresh coconut, and apple peel, and then it has jasmine, magnolia, freesia, and sambac in the heart, and then coconut cream, white sandalwood, and cottonwoods as the base. So it is a very, like I said, there's two notes of coconut in there, but also has some apple and some freesia and some very nice fresh smelling scents. You'll notice if you've watched some of my past Scent Saturday videos that a lot of the notes that I like, especially like the apple and the freesia, feature in a lot of my favorite perfumes. So I guess that says something about the perfumes that I like. I like very fresh, fruity scents, and this one is definitely like that, but with the coconut, it adds a little bit of an extra twist to it, and I really, really like that about it. So I actually sprayed it on my wrist, but it smells, I don't know, you can definitely smell the, I think it's the coconut, but then also the cotton and the sandalwood that you kind of get, that almost takes away some of the strength of the coconut and just really evens it out. And then I can also smell the mandarin and the apple, the very kind of fruity sweet scent at the end of it. So I really, really like this perfume, and I think that if you like a lot of the other perfumes that I've mentioned in past Scent Saturday videos, then I think you'll definitely like this one. The only reason I would say steer clear of this is if you don't like coconut scents, because that is probably going to be something that will definitely turn you off this perfume. So this perfume is fairly widely available. It's available in department stores, then also perfume shops, but then I've also seen this in Priceline. I actually picked up this bottle in Priceline for, I think it was on sale for $17 or $19, so it is quite inexpensive, and then the price obviously goes up as the bottles get a little bit bigger. So it's not overly expensive, which is great, because I think it's very accessible for a lot of people. And I would definitely say this is more of a young person scent. I think this would be great for someone in their teens, early teens, 20s. I think it's definitely a young person scent. I don't know if you bought this for your grandma, if they would like it, but it is a very fun and fresh and girly scent, and I think it is more of a daytime scent, and I think it is more for the summer, spring months, although I will definitely be wearing it in winter, because I think like it'll make me feel like summer's there even when it's cold and raining and really dreary. So overall, I really, really like this scent, and I really recommend checking it out. In terms of how long it lasts, I don't think it's the most long-wearing perfume, but it'll definitely last you a few hours and you'll be able to still smell it. And I think it makes a really cute addition to your perfume collection, just sitting there on your shelf on display. These little dolls are really, really cute. So that is all I have to say about this perfume. If you have any more questions about it, let me know in the comments below. And if you have any recommendations, maybe based on this perfume, if you've smelt this and think you would recommend another perfume that smells similar or something that you think I would like, please let me know in the comments below, because I would love to hear about it. And other than that, I hope you guys are all having a fantastic day, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Bye!